A moment of silence for the fellow rangers who lost their lives this year. 5 died in South Africa and just over 50 on the continent. Attacks on visitors to the Table Mountain National Park have been frequent. With World Rangers Day commemorations underway, Sandpark says there's a need to rethink how rangers are trained as urban crime spills into the country's national parks.
The training which we give to our rangers, we need to adapt to that setup because our rangers were originally trained to protect and conserve the biodiversity of the national park. But most of the serious threats, especially in this area, which faces our rangers, is criminal activities which is done by people. So it changes the entire modalities of a ranger today.
Rangers say while they patrol the hotspots, they are faced with the unique situation of a park with no borders.
We are looking at the different hotspots, so every day, and as we know, it's an open access park, and with it, we also have crime displacements. Basically, we are an urban park where you've got the city right in the center, and we've got a lot of crime overspilling into from the city into the national park. So that is one of our challenges, and we're working closely with our stakeholders, South African Police Services, as well as the City of Cape Town law enforcement agencies.
Civilian organization Table Mountain Watch says the installation of technology like drones and cameras will make a significant difference in curbing criminality at the Table Mountain National Park. It says there have been 14 attacks on tourists on Table Mountain in about 23 incidents this year alone. Vanessa Poonah, SABC News, Cape Town.